Yeah, man. So Omar, in this market stadium, we have seen a lot of amazing charts where we can get a position in. And if you look at diversifying your portfolio, we had a big chunk in Ferocity. We still have a big part of our portfolio into this Ferocity, of course, in this token. But we decided to diversify more and more because we believe in a lot of different type of areas in blockchain, different types of technologies. Omar, could you like show what tokens we decided to purchase and in what industry it is?
Yeah, so since the beginning, we've been very vocal on the coins we've been buying, right? We've been sharing a lot of Veracity, Realio, Zero Knowledge Network, as well as USA, which was one of our latest additions, although it's not that latest since we've invested in it like month or month and a half ago, but it was a pre-sale, but we're going to touch on it in a little bit. But to talk quick about Veracity, we made some sniper entries here, although I have to say Robin and I were here invested already since this zone right here. I mean, we've invested a lot of money here. We showed it already on our website, so a few screenshots because Robin and I are friends and we share a group of with another friend of us where we shared these ideas and then decided to create this group. But we've invested a lot in here. And then as well as here, but the group was already open by then and we communicated in the group that this is one of the best options to purchase at the moment. It did quite well since this bottom here. It did quite well. It did roughly 120%. But if you take from the low of the beginning of the year, then it did a 291%. But if you calculate in that first top, it did close to a 500%. So these are some pretty solid returns when it comes to market conditions, right? I mean, there are another tokens that did 20-30x, of course, but those were at their infancy super risky to buy in, and anyone could have bought in, to be honest, right? It's just about the risk tolerance. And to be also completely honest with you guys, I wasn't that involved in the market here as I am right now. I was involved in Veracity because I'm a long-term holder, but wasn't really like trading or finding new gems like we are doing right now, right? But to get back into it, it's doing quite well. It's doing a cup and handle or a W. It's still bullish anyways. Both are very bullish. An uptrend has been made since from this low we broke, we broke this high from here. So that starts a new trend. Here we have a higher low. And currently we're sitting in this uptrend and we're waiting to make a higher high. However, we are right below this major resistance line, which we didn't manage to break last time and we fell down and now we're retrying it. And what we see ourselves now in is just a small little range, if you will, right? So we touch this upper channel here, and then likely, if the law of gravity applies here, then we're going to revisit this bottom channel here, or at least the bottom, the middle line, sorry. And from there, we either bounce from here or from here. But I think, to be honest, we might have a fair chance just from bouncing from the middle, as we have a lot of events coming in for Veracity in the coming weeks, aka month as well. It could be a month as well. And basically, we have POV migration news, right? POV are proof of view tokens, which are not calculated in the circulating supply, although people really want to make FUD out of it, right? And there's been a lot of it lately in Veracity, especially in this area right here. Although Tim has been very vocal about it, saying that hey, it's gonna happen in Q1, early Q1, right? Because if you guys know about advertising or just basically about spending seasons, the seasons where people spend the most money is in Christmas, right? So Q4, and for them, it doesn't make any sense since their revenue comes from ads, right? And just in a nutshell, right? Not ads per se, but protecting ads, so to speak, verifying ad views. So it's just not smart from their end of from their end to start doing POV migration right now at their busiest quarter, right? So that's one. Then we have quarterly burns, quarterly review, 2024 roadmap, and Vera ads, right? Which they announced, and they're going to have an AMA. I think it was next week, actually starting from tomorrow. So not next week, as in 7 days from now, but as in 3 days from now. And yeah, that's going to be quite one to watch, in my opinion, or to listen, because it's going to be in Twitter. But in my opinion, once we break out from here, from this area, it's just going to be a teleportation to first, let's just grab from here. It will be till the 2 cent mark. And once the 2 cent mark is broken, then likely we just head up to 3 and 4 cents. And mostly it's because of the VPVR, right? It's like a volume profile visible range thing. And you can see that once we break this area right here, is there's just no volume. There's literally no volume at all, besides some technical points like this one where we mentioned around the 2 cents area. Once here is just it's going to be a teleportation, and once this one is broken, then we get back here to 3-4 cents, and then everything is just going to start to go faster and faster, because then we'll have 4 or 5 cents, and then we're going to have previous all-time high or previous high, and then all-time high, which this can go very fast, very, very fast. So yeah, in a nutshell, this is Veracity. This is the returns. These are the returns that it has given us the past months, past year, if you will, and the upcoming events in a nutshell. But I would definitely keep a closer eye on it, as it's just, in my opinion, about to explode. So yeah, that's Veracity. When it comes to Realio, we nailed this move, in my opinion. I mean, we bought over here, literally over here. So right at this sort of scam wick, we bought at a great time, great time. And it gave us a 400% return. I mean, what else do we want in this short period of time, right? It's just like in a month. So a month and a half. So it's great to see that, markets are getting back. Some narratives are popping up, like real world assets, AI, gaming. Those are kind of popping up, even privacy, right? And we call this range, and although in the weekly you can't see it that well, on the daily you can see that, hey, we formed that range. Here's the high, here's the low, and then now we're just bouncing around in the middle. And Realio has an amazing community. So yeah. And lately they had some news regarding their Realioverse. They rebranded to Districts. People really got confused because of that. I do agree that the way they announced it, it was more as if something super huge was coming, like a sick exchange or sick partnership or whatever. But it was just a rebranding of their Realioverse. So yeah, that was a bit of a bummer, if you will. But yeah, overall, I think it was just a nice move to rebrand that name and not call it Realioverse, and to have it sort of as a different vertical, right? Because it's not only real world assets, but also metaverse project, right? Which is another narrative to keep an eye on, especially also how Realio tokenomics are built. Guys, if you don't know it, I would invite you please to go and look it up, because it's really insane. And the Realioverse adds a lot of value to Realio, although it's not Realioverse anymore, it's Districts. So in a nutshell, this was Rio. Not as big as an update like for Vra, but it's still good. It's more than good. And this is barely, I think, like 40 million market cap, 45 million market cap. So also relatively small for the amount of capital that's about to come in the coming months, especially for real world assets, right? So yeah, that's that. Zero Knowledge Network, 20 million market cap. It has performed incredibly for us. We've been buying literally right below this resistance here. And then in this bounce over here, we've been very vocal about it as well on our group. And we've shared it literally many, many times. It's included in our updates, which we do almost every other day. And it is just is an absolute monster. I mean, take a look at this. 337% since our buy, roughly. This is some crazy gains, and barely just in a month, right? So 20 million, as I said, 20 million market cap, still super cheap. And we have a documentation dropping up really soon. We have the teaser for their node, right, that will allow you to protect your privacy at home as well, powered by zero knowledge network. It is just undervalued as hell right now. Although we see that fundamentals are catching up to, we see that PA price is actually catching up to the fundamentals. Community is insane. Team is even better. Super professionals. And I would highly recommend to keep this one, guys, in your portfolio. So yeah, this was Zero Knowledge Network. And then for the last one, USA, which is Dead Press, which is like Dead President. I know on the weekly, it might not look appetizing, but on the daily, we see that it had an amazing launch. I'm going to put the 4 hour now because it just launched. Literally, it launched last week, 6 days ago, to be fair. So it launched. It had an amazing launch. We received 10% of our initial back because we participated in the pre-sale, which was on 7 cents, which is somewhere here on the bottom. Let me see if I can find 7 cents. Yeah. For us, it did, 33x in literally a matter of a day or two. It's just, what can we say? We're fucking, of course, super happy that we invested here in. Now, at the moment, we're sitting on an overall profit of 13x, 14x. And guys, what can we say? I mean, if you guys want to invest here, I would wait perhaps to get in around this area, just a little bit, wait for like this wick at 82 cents and add around this zone over here, right? Because the way the tokenomics are built is as follows. 10% unlocked instantly for everyone that participated on the presale, and then 6 month soft lockup daily. So people get daily tokens for 6 months. And this is now what's causing this sort of dump, right? We have some catalysts for the upcoming weeks, right? Which is new games for the platform and the USA token integration on the platform, which will allow to absorb all these tokens from circulation and allow users to spend them on the platform, right? Robin and I played it smart since we have already some NFTs that we got from the presale as well for free. So that's already covering all our costs, basically. But our 10%, we sold it here for our initial investment. So our initial investment is already completely out, and we're just rocking out with the profits, right? Although it's a lot of money still, but our initial investment is already safe. So when it goes to that, our risk management strategy, it's already plain. Right, since we don't have any risk more involved besides the profits, the rewards that we got. So that's that. But we shared this as well in the group when we participated. As you can see, the maximum buy was 7K and the minimum was 100. But we put it quite a bit because we wanted to get the NFTs, and we have a few NFTs as well. And you get it was by 750 investment, 750 USDC, you got an NFT. And I think it was just a no-brainer for us. So yeah, this was the special rate. Pub is just like a dead token. It's just for representation because the USA token didn't launch the same day as this ended. So the pub token was just as a representation. And the DEX rate was 51, right? And guys, I mean, this was a huge winner for us. 33x in just 2 days, initial investment out. We got free NFTs that are contributing to the ecosystem, giving us rewards from the platform. Guys, what can we say? It was just a blessing. This one was a blessing. And GambleFi, this is in the industry, GambleFi. At the moment, I think it has, let me check the market cap, but I think it's not even 2 million at the moment. Yeah. So it's sitting right at 2 million market cap. It's just insanely low. Good liquidity as well for the market cap. It's like 25% ish. I would highly recommend to get this one on your watch list and just DCA or whenever you guys feel like it. We are very vocal about it. We are very vocal about everything, basically. So I would recommend you guys to give a look at GambleFi. It's a new narrative. We've seen already Rollbit, how it performed. We have already seen Dubs, how it performed. And this is already performing. So, yeah, I would definitely, guys, recommend you to, yeah, to keep an eye on this one. And then for the rest, we're looking still for gaming tokens, for infrastructure tokens that are meeting our criteria of tokenomics, community, project, team, you know? So those are our main criteria that we want to check off, tick off. Yeah, if you guys have any suggestions, please show us. Please do let us know. And yeah, and preferably market cap below 30 million because we, since it's early stages bull market, right? We really want to be on this sort of low cap coins. Although 30 million is not really that low anymore. It's more like a mid-ish. So yeah, below anything below 30 million, guys, shill us and we'll do some research and let you guys know. This was the, yeah, I guess, mini update. And Robin, if you don't have any other questions, then I think this was it.
I think we're good, man.
So yeah, man, to wrap it up, this was one of the episodes of our weekly trading updates. And I hope you learned a lot, man. So thanks for watching. And if you want to see our 500K portfolio, learn to improve your charting skills or have one-on-one calls with us, just visit our website. It's brand new and it's called Quotum.org.